Hi children, welcome back to your social science class. Today we are going to start new block, block 10, Northern Plains. We already studied which type of land is called plains. Yes, it is flat and fertile land. Flat and fertile lands are called plains. Flat and fertile lands. Land are called plains, that we already studied. Then, where is this northern plains are located? Yes, northern plains are located in the south of northern mountain. Northern plains are located in the south of northern mountain. That means just below of northern mountains it is northern plains. Yes, which are the states it lie between? Yes, it lie between Punjab in the east. It lie between Punjab in the west and Assam in the east. Okay, so which are the state it lies between? It lie between the states of Punjab in the west and Assam in the east. Okay, then we know, see children, this northern mountain, where is northern mountains? We already studied, it is in the northern border of India. So when we look at the physical map of India, so this northern border of India means it is the top part, right? So in the this brown colored area shows mountain. So just below of northern mountain we can see a green colored area here. See, green colored area we can see here. This is northern plains. So this northern plains are starting from Punjab. We told it lie between Punjab in west and Assam in the east. So it start, the green colored area we can see, this is northern plains. So it start from Punjab and it lie between Punjab and Assam. Assam is here. Okay, so these are the states it lie between. Okay, and we have to know this, it is flat and fertile land we told. How these northern plains are, how the northern plains become very fertile, how these northern plains are formed? Yes, these northern plains are formed by the rivers that originate from Himalaya. They carry some sand, silt, like that things, and deposit near the river banks. Okay, because of this depositional activities of the rivers, this northern plains are formed. Okay, that is why this northern plains are very fertile. Okay, why this northern plains are very fertile? Because these rivers originate from Himalaya that flow through the northern plains. Okay, while they are flowing through the northern plains, it carries some pebbles, sand, silt, etc. and deposit near the river banks. This make this part of this northern plains become very fertile. So this kind of fertile land, the crops can grow very easily. Okay, so these areas are very useful or very suitable for cultivation. Got it? Okay, so that is northern plains. This much only you have to know about northern plains. Then we told which are the rivers that form this northern plains. So mainly this northern plains are divided into three river basin, or this river northern plains are formed by three rivers. Which are the three rivers? First one, it is Satluj river. Second one, it is Ganga river. And third one, it is Brahmaputra. Okay, so this northern plains are formed by these three rivers. Okay, so first you have to study two new words in this part. Okay, one, it is tributary. What is tributary? Okay, what is tributary, children? Yes, tributaries are the small rivers that join into large river, that are called tributaries. So river Yamuna is the tributary of river Ganga. Okay, so big rivers have many tributaries, small rivers will be there. Okay, so what is tributary? Yes, small rivers that join into big rivers. big rivers are called tributaries. Okay, so a main river, we can say Ganga river. Ganga river has many tributaries. Okay, so one Yamuna is the tributary of river Ganga. Like that way, many tributaries will be there for big rivers or large rivers. So what is tributary? Tributaries are small rivers that join into big rivers. Okay, so this river Ganga has Ganga, Satluj and Brahmaputra has many tributaries. Okay, now you have to study one more new word, that is basin. What is basin? Basin, a basin is a basin means main rivers and its tributaries flow through an area. It is called basin. Okay, that means main rivers, example river Satluj, Ganga, Brahmaputra and all main rivers, these rivers and its tributaries flow through an area. It is called basin. Okay, so main rivers and its tributaries, main rivers and its tributaries flow through an area. Flow through an area is called, through an area, it is called basin. First we have to study tributary, then only we can study what is basin. So tributaries are the small rivers that join into big rivers, but basins are the main rivers and its tributaries flow through an area are called basin. So see children, this northern plains are divided into three river basins. Yes, which are they? Yes, Satluj river basin, Ganga river basin and Brahmaputra river basin. Okay, in detail about each river basin we will study in the next class. Okay, so today we studied what is plains. Okay, flat and fertile lands are called plains. Then we studied where these northern plains are located. Northern plains are located in the south of northern mountain. It lie between the state of Punjab in the west and Assam in the east. Okay, then we studied how, why this land northern plains become very fertile. It is because of the rivers flow from flow through the northern plains, carry sand and silt and deposit near the river banks. It make this land very fertile. Then we studied what is tributary. Tributaries are the small rivers that join into big rivers. Okay, then we studied what is basin. Basins are the main rivers that main rivers and its tributaries flow into a flow through an area, that is basin. So we know these northern plains are divided into three river basin: Satluj river basin, Ganga river basin and Brahmaputra river basin. Okay, this much only we have to study today. Now everybody need to take your workbook. Our S1, it is River Plains of India. Look at the river map of India. Use pencil to draw lines and divide the northern rivers into three groups: west, central, east and on the basis where they are flowing. So we know west, which river is flowing through west? Yes, it is Satluj river. So we can see in the west of India it is Satluj river. Central part of India, that means it flow through Uttar Pradesh, Ganga river. Ganga river is in the central part of flowing through central part of India. And next one, it is east, which river is flowing through the eastern part of India? It is Brahmaputra, Arunachal Pradesh and Assam. It is mainly flowing through Arunachal Pradesh and Assam. Okay, so you can mark like that way with pencil. Second question is, look at the map and locate and color the northern plains on the map. So first question, write the names of three river plains of India and name one or two states of each river plain. So first we can mark the river plains of India. So we studied northern plains are divided into three, isn't it? Satluj river basin, Ganga river basin and Brahmaputra river basin. So we can first mark Satluj river basin here. This is first arrow, that is Satluj river basin. Then second, in the middle we can mark Ganga river basin. Central part it is Ganga river basin. Then third one, it is Brahmaputra river basin. Okay, this third arrow we can mark Brahmaputra river basin. Okay, so we can write some of the states these rivers are flowing through. Okay, so first we can mark Satluj river basin. Satluj river flow through Punjab and Haryana. That's two states we can mark: Satluj river, Punjab and Haryana. Ganga river, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh. Ganga river, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh we can mark. Then Brahmaputra, we can mark Arunachal Pradesh and Assam. Arunachal Pradesh and Assam we can mark. mark Brahmaputra. Okay, then how is the river, third question, how is the river Ganga useful to the people living in Uttar Pradesh? Will people living in Punjab or Assam enjoy the same benefits of river Ganga? So how can we give the answer, children? Yes, this river Ganga, the people living in Uttar Pradesh will get the benefit of river Ganga, right? It is because of these rivers are mainly flowing through Uttar Pradesh. So how this river will be beneficial to the people living in Uttar Pradesh? Yes, the river Ganga provides water to drink and for agriculture to the people living in the Uttar Pradesh. So how it is beneficial to the people? Yes, the river Ganga provides water to drink and for agriculture to the people living in Uttar Pradesh. And we can write one more question is there. Will people living in Punjab or Assam enjoy the same benefits of river Ganga? No, the people living in Punjab and Assam will not get any benefit from river Ganga, because we know Punjab Satluj river, then that benefit will get to the people in Punjab. And in the case of Assam, Brahmaputra river flow through this Assam, so it will get the benefit from Brahmaputra river only. Okay, so this is the way you can write the answer. Now we have to discuss some practice questions. So practice question number 2, what is basin? What is a basin? Yes, basin means we know this main rivers and its tributaries flow through an area, it is called basin. Okay, and you can write there are 3 river basins in the northern plains: Ganga river basin, Satluj river basin and Brahmaputra river basin. That also you can add. Okay, then next question, we can write 6th question, right? 1 or 2 important features of the northern plains. So we can write this northern plains. Flat and fertile lands are called plains. Then this northern plains lie between Punjab in the west and Assam in the east. That also we can give. And another thing we can give, it is formed by the rivers deposit sand and silt. The rivers that flow through the northern plains deposit sand and silt. Okay, so like that way you can write. Then we know it is divided, it is formed by 3 rivers mainly: Satluj river, Ganga river, Brahmaputra river. Like that you can write any point by your own answers you can give. Okay, so this way you can complete the practice question. So this much enough for today's class. Hope you all understood today's class. So we can meet in the next class. Okay, bye.